To keep things simple, let's assume that there's a single CPU. Each guest operating system is already multiplexing the processes that it is currently hosting on the CPU in a non-virtualized setting also. So each operating system has a ready queue of processes that can be scheduled on the CPU. But there is this hypervisor that is sitting in between a guest operating system, its ready queue, and the CPU. So the first part of what the hypervisor has to do is to give an illusion of ownership of the CPU for each of the virtual machines so that each virtual machine can schedule the processes that it currently has in its ready queue on the CPU. So if you look at it from the hypervisor's point of view, it has to have a precise way of accounting the time that a particular VM uses on the CPU from the point of view of billing the different customers. That's the key thing that the hypervisor is worried about, that it gave the CPU for a certain amount of time to this VM, certain amount of time to this VM, and so on. Now, for the time that has been allocated, for instance, this virtual machine, how this virtual machine is using the CPU time, what processes it is scheduling on the CPU, the hypervisor doesn't care about them. So commensurate with whatever is the scheduling policy in force in a particular guest operating system, that guest operating system is free to schedule its pool of processes on the CPU for the time that has been given to it by the hypervisor. Now, similar to the policy that we discussed for memory allocation, one straightforward way to share the CPU among the guest operating systems is to give a share of the CPU, a proportional share of the CPU for each guest operating system, commensurate with the service agreement that this virtual machine has with the hypervisor. This is called the proportional share scheduler, and it is used in the VMware ESX server. Another approach is to use a fair share scheduler, which is going to give a fair share of the CPU for each of the guest operating system, an equal share to each of the guest operating systems running on top of the hypervisor. Both of these strategies, proportional share scheduler or a fair share scheduler, are straightforward conceptual mechanisms, and you can learn more about them from the assigned readings for this course. In either of these cases, the hypervisor has to account for the time used on the CPU on behalf of a different guest during the allocated time for a particular guest. And this can happen, for instance, if there is an external interrupt that is fielded by the CPU that is intended for this VM while a process that belongs to this VM is currently executing on the CPU. So this is accounting that the hypervisor would keep in order to make sure that any time that was stolen away from a particular VM in order to service an external interrupt that did not belong to this VM, it'll get rewarded for later on by the accounting procedure in the hypervisor. We've discussed this issue already in the context of operating system extensibility, specifically when we discussed the exakernel approach to extensibility. So it's not a new problem. It is just that this problem occurs in the hypervisor setting also.